In this tutorial, we'll review how to perform a photovoltaic simulation with battery storage in ClimateStudio. This workflow is currently only available through the Grasshopper interface. With Rhino open, type Grasshopper into the command line. Navigate to the ClimateStudio tab and click the first button on the left. Drag the component to the canvas. You'll be able to see what version of ClimateStudio you're using with this component. Make sure to stay updated. By clicking Select, a list of pre-made workflow templates will be listed. Inside Radiation Map and PV, select PV System with Battery. This workflow template is immediately imported into the Grasshopper canvas. I'll just zoom out so we can get a full view of the script. As you can see, the workflow is divided into two groups, the building load simulation and the PV and battery simulation. Let's start from the top. In our input geometry group, both the PV panels and the context geometry are being defined. This workflow template, like many others in the ClimateStudio template library, come with pre-made geometry to illustrate the workflow. By right-clicking these components, I can turn on the Rhino preview. You should refine your model prior to running a real simulation, as this geometry is a simplified shoebox energy model with no interior thermal zone divisions and no windows. Our context geometry is being fed to the zone settings component of the building load simulation group. Click on the settings button to open up the zone settings user interface and assign your loads, conditioning, and envelope values accordingly. This data is then used inside the simulate component, where you can calculate the hourly energy requirements for your building. Note that a more detailed energy model would be needed to get a realistic sense of your building loads. This is just an example of the workflow. Click the Run button inside the red circle and watch Energy Plus execute in the command prompt. Energy requirement results are quickly populated into the graph to the right. Drag the Day of Year Index slider to visualize different weeks of the year. Annual building load metrics are also given. Site energy use intensity is an indicator of the energy efficiency of the site as a whole and is calculated by dividing total energy consumed annually by the total gross floor area. For comparison, and to help designers meet the American Institute of Architects 2030 challenge, the AIA site EUI baseline is also given. Taking one more look at our graph, we can see that energy use requirements are separated by equipment, fans, lighting, hot water, heating, and cooling. I've turned off hot water for the simulation, which is why it's not visible on the graph, but if we scroll through our day of the year index, we can see how the loads vary through the seasons. The graph is showing hours of the week on the x-axis and loads in kilowatt hours per meter squared on the y-axis. Now that we've run the building load simulation, it's time to run the PV and battery simulation. Here, our building's energy utilization throughout the year based on time and date is visualized as a heat map, and this data, along with the PV panel and context geometry, are being fed into the custom ClimateStudio PV component. We also have components for our PV panel efficiency, which is 0.2, and for the battery capacity, which is set to 100 kilowatt hours. Double-click the text box to update these values. By clicking Run, Energy Plus once again executes, this time to calculate the PV electricity generation and battery utilization. Two graphs are populated to the right, along with some annual PV and battery performance metrics. We have our total building energy requirements in kilowatt hours, total PV energy generated in kilowatt hours, total exported power to the grid in kilowatt hours, and total imported grid power required in kilowatt hours. These metrics are also given on a weekly basis in the graph below, labeled Weekly Facility Metrics. Weekly building energy requirements are labeled as load in red. Weekly PV energy generated is labeled as total yield in pink. Export in green and import in yellow represent the total electricity that is sold to and required from the grid, respectively. This graph also includes battery state, represented in blue, which is the amount of battery capacity that is available. Our other graph visualizes weekly electricity generated and can also be updated using the day of year index slider. Each PV panel is represented by their own color and line on the graph, with kilowatt hours on the y-axis and hours of the week on the x-axis. For each panel, you can see a spike in the yield for each day of the week. Now you know how to simulate a PV system with battery storage using ClimateStudio for Grasshopper. Thank you for watching and happy simulations!